I don't know why I'm expected to leave the house when you're having some kind of a
midlife crisis.
Or something.
I'm getting Will the Herculaneum action figure he wanted.
What are you talking about?
Christmas. The kids.
Try not to forget that, too.
This is really not working for me, Vic.
This has been going on since last Christmas. How long do you think this separation thing is going to last?
I don't know.
Well, I hope you figure out whatever you need to figure out soon, because the rest of your family's lives are falling apart.
And have O'Sullivan bring all the cases dealing with trademark infringement.
Okay, but you actually asked...
Who's that redheaded paralegal? Have her sent to my office.
Got it.
I wanted to write up a draft for the Simons case.
You
told
me to make sure...
And what about the Jack Simons? Have we done that too?
Excuse me!
Kristine, if you have something to say, just say it.
Your daughter. You're supposed to pick her up from school.
What time is it? Not again. Give this to Judge Murphy.
Okay.
And explain. I will review the case tomorrow morning with him, but I'm sorry I missed him, and I had to go pick up my daughter.
Oh. Hey, Dad.
Hey, honey. I'm sorry.
It's no problem. Tracy's mom dropped me off.
We got tied up in this deposition, and I blew it. Sorry.
This kind of stuff never happened when you and Mom were together.
Yeah. Tell her that.
Come on, we're gonna be late. Karate practice? In like 15 minutes? Seriously, Dad, don't you remember anything?
Is he always like that?
Always.
Hey, no teaming up.
That is really kind of funny.
No, it wasn't.
Oh, hey, I made it.
I'm sorry. Hi.
Kristine.
What is she doing here?
I don't know.
Your emails. You said we'd go for a swim before we worked.
What?
Oh, I'm sure you'll have a great time. Uh-oh.
Kristine, why are you here?
The Bronski case. The new trial date. You told me to bring the files out here.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
But I left you a message. And then you emailed me.
What have you done?
Yes. Yes, next Monday would be fine. Jack, listen, thank you. You've really saved our neck on this one. Yeah. I know. I'm sorry to bother you on Christmas Eve. You have a great holiday.
Crisis averted.
Everything's taken care of.
It's good.
I'm sorry about before at the house.
Oh, well, it's not your fault.
So, I thought you and your wife weren't together.
Well, we're not. It's a whole messy story, but the realization that we came to is that it's over.
That's a shame. I thought she'd forgiven you.
Forgiven me? What did I ever do that was wrong?
Are you kidding? You're impossible. You don't listen. All you do is yell, do this, do that. You even forgot your own kids. I don't know how she put up with you for this long. I wouldn't have.
But you don't understand how much work it takes to support a family.
All I know is that it is Christmas Eve, and you are sitting here calling attorneys. What's the point in working so hard to support a family if you don't ever get to enjoy them?
You know, you're not nearly as nice as you act.
Can you blame me? I'm stuck with my boss on Christmas Eve. Can I go now?
Merry Christmas.